One by one, as years roll on, we are called upon to fulfill these sad duties of respect to our departed comrade. The present, full of the cares that beset all nations, whether engaged in war or peace, fades away as we look back on the day our comrade left his home to defend his country. Imbued by a spirit of devotion and inspired by an undying love of his native land, he gladly went forth and joined with comrades, both young and old, to preserve our heritage of freedom. We trust that the example set by our comrade will prove a glorious beacon to the youth of our country, who may be called to uphold the honor of our flag. As the years roll on, we too shall have finished our fight, shall be laid to rest, and our souls follow the long column of the realms above, as all unfolding death, and hour by hour, shall mark his recruits. We are here assembled to pay a lasting tribute of respect to our departed comrade. When the call of our country was heard, John Carroll answered, "Self was forgotten in the cause of the greater good." Bravely he marched away with an abiding faith in his God, his country, and his flag. The red of our country's flag was made more red by his heroism, the white more stainlessly pure by the motives which impelled him, and in the starry field of our nation's glorious banner, the blue has been glorified by the service it had given for American ideals. Comrade Chaplain, will you invoke the divine blessing?
Uncover, parade rest.
Please bow your hands. Almighty and merciful God and Father of all, I see your hand of mercy. In the depth of our sorrow, we realize the truth of the inspired words. I am the resurrection and the life, that he who believes in me, though he were dead, yet he shall live. As comrade after comrade departs this life, we march on with our ranks growing thinner. Help us to be faithful to you and to one another. We ask that you would look mercy upon all of us here assembled, and with your compassion and tenderness, console and comfort those who bereave by the hand of death. Heavenly Father, bless our nation with freedom, peace, and righteousness. And through our sovereign and Holy Spirit's favor, may we all meet at last before your throne of grace in heaven. To your great name shall be the praise forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Cover.
Cover.
Comrades, let us so live that within the keeper of the eternal record shall call our names for the last time. Those we leave behind may say of us, as we now say of this comrade, here lies all that is mortal of a true-hearted comrade and a fearless defender of his country and flag. Officers, you will now perform the last duties of your station. Senior Vice Commander.
I place this symbol of purity on this altar. May each future generation emulate the unselfish courage of all men and women who fought for our freedom.
Junior Vice Commander.
On behalf of Post 741, Veterans of World War, United States, I place this tribute on this altar as a symbol of our undying love of our comrade.
Officer of the day.
We place this last token of affection from his comrades in arms upon the altar of our departed comrade and crown his mortal soul with this symbol of victory.
On behalf of our glorious republic, for whose integrity our comrade of the veterans of foreign wars enlisted and served, I place this emblem of our nation, the flag of our country, was his to defend. Its glorious colors shall wave over him as in death, as he did in life, for everyone to behold. To our comrade who has now departed, we render a silent salute.
Hand salute. Ready to.
Comrade in the silent land beyond, wherever your mortal remains may rest, these solemn services we hold in tribute to you. This concludes our ceremony, and I want to introduce you to John's nephew, Larry Higgins, United States Air Force, retired, who is going to deliver the flag to his beautiful wife, Delilah.
And salute.
I'm going to put this back over to Chris, and we're going to open this mic up for people to share some of their reminders of John, who is quite the character.
Danny boy, the pipes are calling. From glen to glen and down the mountainside, the summer's gone and all of the road is falling. Tis you must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the or when the valley's hushed and white with snow, 'tis I'll be here in the sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny, love you so, and when he comes and all of the flowers are dying, and I am dead as dead I well may be. You'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me, and I shall hear the soft tread above me, and on my grave will warmer, sweeter be, and ye shall abandon, tell me that you love me, and I shall sleep in peace until you come.
I'm certain I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew, but through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to